What is up, lads? It's CM9 here. We got them back. We got the Chelsea back, boys. We've got our resilience back. We've got our swagger back. We've got our goal-scoring ability back. We have literally got them back. And I couldn't be happier. This brand new guard, this new English core that is working in unison with everybody else on the pitch. We have got the best core, and we are managed right now by the best possible manager right now, Frank Lampard. Legend on the pitch, legend on the touchline. He is just getting everything right with this team. Look, I know it's been a little bit slow getting this team up to where it needs to be, but my gosh, us Chelsea fans are about to wait for it, and well, we are getting good results from it. Tammy Abraham, Mason Mount, Callum Hudson-Odoi, Tomori. That mould and that mixture with all the other experienced players on the pitch like Jorginho, Willian, Azpilicueta, it's looking like real positivity coming from this team right now, and I'm liking every single minute of it. 4-1 victory over Southampton, 4 wins in a row. There's a lot to be smiling about as a Chelsea fan right now. So let's just see what Lampard put out today. I've got the team sheet on my phone right here. So Lampard goes with a 4-2-3-1 today. He plays 4 at the back. So Azpilicueta, Zuma, Tomori and Alonso. Then we have Kante and Jorginho sitting in our midfield. Then we have 3 in attack. Willian, Mason Mount, Hudson-Odoi, Tammy Abraham up front. Solid team. Solid team. So first half, it was a bit slow. I'm not saying everything was perfect in the first half, but it started off very slow because it looked as if we were trying to invite pressure. Passing the ball back to the goalkeeper, that was a little bit worrying, but we picked ourselves up really, really quickly. We got that first goal, Callum Hudson-Odoi with the assist, and Tammy Abraham tries to meet the ball, lobs the goalkeeper. Defender tries to clear it, but the ball goes over the line anyway. Goal line technology was spot on. We didn't really need VAR for that, so the ball went over the line despite the clearance, and we go 1-0 up. Another goal for Tammy Abraham. He now is level with Aguero in the number of goals scored this season so far. I think, yeah, he's level with Aguero, so that's great. Definitely level with the number of goals because Man City didn't win today. They lost 2-0 against Wolves. Hey! So that was a bit of a shocker. And then Mason Mount makes it 2-0 with some excellent link-up play with Hudson-Odoi and Willian. I think he actually won the ball originally, got it to Willian. Willian held onto the ball, played it in to Mount, and then he finished it off. Fantastic. But then Southampton scored from some bit of a defensive mix-up, courtesy of, I think, Tomori. I think Tomori at the back made... He didn't look very comfortable in defence for Chelsea in the first half, which was unfortunate for him, but he did get better in the second half, which was good because we didn't concede. But we'll get to our defence in a moment. Kante got into space and he shot it, deflected, went into the bottom corner for 3-1. And then later on, Batshuayi, late in the game in the second half, some good link-up play from Pulisic coming on. Oh my God, Pulisic was on the pitch. He came on a little bit later, and then he slotted it in for 4-1. So real solid performance. Now let's talk about our defending, because our defending was better today. Better today. Remember what I said about resilience earlier in the video? Well, today we look better. And the reason why we look better is because we were defending set pieces. This whole time, we have struggled with set pieces. Not being able to defend them, constantly conceding goals from them. We were actually defending them. We were actually defending set pieces. We were actually man-marking. We were actually positioning ourselves right from the corners that Southampton were taking. And, well, you'd expect at a venue like St. Mary's. I was expecting a venue like St. Mary's to concede goals from set pieces today, but we didn't. The only time we did concede was from a goal of absolutely nowhere. I don't know what the hell was going on with our defence. Bit of a scrap, technically. But our set piece defending today, set piece zonal marking, was brilliant. It just shows you that we've actually been working on it. There's actually some improvement. Today definitely showed that. So full marks to our zonal marking, full marks to our set pieces. Okay, yeah, we conceded, but still, this is something we need to work on. Yes, we didn't get a clean sheet, but we can take everything that we've done here and we can continue to work. We can continue. It's still very, very early in the season. Okay, we shouldn't expect to chase for a title right now because Liverpool are running away with it right now. But we can gradually get better. We can gradually take what we've done today and continue to work and continue to work. So we can't argue with that. Second half, we look more resilient. Okay, there were times where we conceded a few fouls, but Southampton's free kick taking, James Ward-Prowse, not technically the best, but you know, it's good signs, good signs. Now let's talk about going forward now, going up front. Willian was excellent today. Like a million, gazillion, trillion out of 10 for Willian. And the reason why is because Willian was, he was the glue today. Willian, he was the guy that created so much. He worked off Mason Mount. Just proves you that Mason Mount and Willian can work together. If you place Mason Mount in the centre of midfield rather than play him up top, where he had a little bit of trouble against Lille, if you remember. So when he played up front against Lille, didn't really do very much because there wasn't an opportunity for him to get the ball and move forward with it. If he plays a little bit further deep in the midfield, in the centre, he gets more work done. He plays a little bit more like Lampard used to do. And this is the reason why Lampard is getting the better out of him, because he knows how to play that midfield role. And he's giving everything that Mount needs to know to play that role. So if he plays Mount in that position, he gets more work done. The same can be said for Willian. Willian and Mount worked brilliantly together. Jorginho as well did okay as well, with those balls into the box and giving Abraham more opportunities. Abraham was great as well today, linking up play. And then you got Kante free to not only get the ball forward and be that extra man, but also get back and protect the back four. This is the solidarity that we've needed for so long. And even before this, I've seen countless games in the past where we've just not had any room to do anything. And we're leaving several gaps at the back for the opposition to exploit. Today, we didn't show any signs of that. And it was solid. Everyone was in unison. Everyone was doing things in advance. And it was brilliant. It was excellent. Let's talk about Hudson-Odoi now. Hudson-Odoi, great assists today. I thought he assisted Abraham really well in the first half. There is one thing I would like to say about Hudson-Odoi. For God's sake, learn to finish. That's all. That's all I've got to say about Hudson-Odoi. Time and time again, Willian played him in, and he needs to look up before he tries to shoot the ball, because there was a chance that he had. I kid you not, if there was somebody else with that opportunity, they would have finished it. They would have known where to put the ball, in the far corner or a little bit close to the keeper on to his right side. We saw a little bit later on Batshuayi do the exact same thing, where Pulisic played him in and he knew exactly where to place the ball in on the underside of the goalkeeper and place it perfectly well. Hudson-Odoi needs to do that as well. He needs to sort of find the right position, look up, know where to place the ball, and then finish it. I didn't see him do that today, and that's the reason why he didn't get on the score sheet. He would have easily got on the score sheet, though. There were some great positions that he played the ball. There was great times where he cut inside, found a good position, but his finishing needs to improve. If he can improve on his finishing, Hudson-Odoi, he will get there. He will be there. He will be right there. Definitely deserved to start today. I really thought he was good today. Really, really excellent. Tammy Abraham. I don't know if I mentioned anything about Tammy Abraham. Great game today. Great game. Got a goal. Leveled with Aguero in terms of goals scored this season. I'm really, really pleased with Tammy Abraham today. Can't argue. Back four, Azpilicueta. Solid game. Can't argue with his performance. Pretty solid game. Kurt Zouma. He was good. He was really, really good, in fact. Like I said earlier when I was talking about set pieces, managed it really well. Great man marking. Knew where the guy was in the set pieces. Now we can improve on this. We've got to take this and we've got to improve on it. Tomori made a few mistakes in the first half. Very, very shaky. Like I said, I think Yunus said this in a video. You can't expect every player to be perfect. You've got to expect a few mistakes here or there. These players are going to learn from these mistakes. You can't go an entire season looking like the perfect defender. Does he look better with three at the back instead of four? Possibly. I mean, if he plays alongside Christensen, Zouma in a three-man defence, and you got two left-sided and right-sided midfielders pushed a little bit further up, I think Tomori has a lot more space to command and sort of like, you know what I mean? Like he knows where to, well, he knows where the guy's going to run and he takes charge of that situation. In a four-man defense though, I think he has a little bit of trouble distributing the ball and he makes mistakes. And that's what Tomori does. And I think he has to work, he has to adapt to this kind of formation if Lampard has to switch to that formation. If Lampard switches to the other formation, which is three in defence, he's fine. But when he's switched back to 4-2-3-1, he's prone to making a few mistakes. But second half, he was a lot more solid alongside Zuma today. Marcus Alonso. I can't believe I'm going to say this, but he actually had a good game. What year is it? Is it 2019? What is he? Is it 2023? He was exceptional. He was actually good. Second half, especially. He was tackling the ball. He was passing the ball to actual players. He was getting shit done. I can't argue with Alonso today. This is like the first time I can actually sit here in front of a camera and have the confidence in saying he actually had a good game. So many times he's done nothing. So many times he's gone up the pitch and he's crossed the ball to nobody and he's failed to track back. Today, he actually got a job done. Tackling was great. Passing was great. Crossing was actually good. I can't argue with Alonso today for the first time ever. I'm actually speechless. There's nothing bad to say about Marcus Alonso today. Really good job. Really good job. Let's talk about our substitutions. Our new substitutions, Christensen, Barkley, Caballero. Reece James didn't get a chance, which was fine. Because, you know, you can't really rush players into doing a job, which is totally fine. Kovacic, Pulisic and Batshuayi. Batshuayi got a goal. Pulisic gave him that assist for that goal. Pulisic was okay when he came on, got an assist, so can't argue. Kovacic, great. Okay, pretty damn good. So today, excellent. Big thumbs up. 4-1. Great victory. We got an international break now. So I guess I do need a break from doing these videos because, well, doing these videos is not easy because you've got to keep talking and talking and talking and talking. It's not easy. But I could do with a break. So yeah, international break after this. So to summarize this game, we were better at our man marking at set pieces today. Willian is the glue to keep everybody together, to keep these guys working off each other. Mount, Hudson-Odoi, Abraham were all fantastic today. Jorginho was great with his distribution of the balls. Marcus Alonso with a surprisingly good game. Tomori, a few mistakes in the first half, but did better. Kurt Zouma did really, really well in the entire game. Azpilicueta, solid game. Kepa didn't really have that much to do because Southampton rarely threatened, let's be honest. And yeah, great game. We've got our swagger back. We've got our Chelsea back. I'm happy. Really, really happy today. We've got to keep this going. We've got to keep it going. Keep it going with this homegrown talented players. I'll tell you something, the transfer ban is the best thing to have happened to us. Can we go to FIFA and say, can we extend the transfer ban? Because we're fine right now. The kids are okay. The kids are okay. We don't have to worry about this. Because if we continue to work like this, keep it going with the switching up of formations, keeping them in the loop with the switching of formations, keep them working off each other, we'll be great. We'll be good. Mason Mount's looking good. Hudson-Odoi is looking good. Abraham, these guys are going to get better. They're going to get better over time. They're going to keep playing alongside each other week in, week out. And it's going to look good. Hudson-Odoi, Abraham and Mount, I think only Mount and Abraham are in the England squad. So hopefully they won't pick up injuries because, you know, we're very prone to picking up injuries during the international break. So hopefully that doesn't happen. But Mount and Abraham are in the England squad. So I really hope that they continue to work and they continue to get better. Lampard hopefully can get the best out of them. And I'm happy. Big thumbs up, guys. Keep working hard, guys. I couldn't be more happy with this group of players. Keep it going. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Check out my social media links in the description. Let me know what you guys thought about that match in the comments down below. Roll on the next 2 weeks. I can't wait, man. Can't wait. Next game, I do believe, is against... I don't know. I think it's against... I don't know. I'll be right back with you. Okay, so after the international break, 19th of October, we face Newcastle United at home. So, relatively easy game. Although, you know, Tottenham said that about a couple of weeks ago and they lost against them. So, You know what I mean? Like, it could be a banana skin, but we've got to keep working. We've got to keep working. We're not Tottenham right now, because Tottenham keep losing, and I love it. But this group of players, Lampard's getting the best out of them. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Until the next video, I shall see you later. Hey door, and peace.